Here's the other one. Or two? Whoop! Whoop! I can't move. It stuck me. It stuck me. Almost dead.
Everyone all right?
Everyone all right? All right. Guerrilla tactics for the win. More bones. Success. Okay. Grenade launcher 3. Surprised I'm not weighed down now. I got more notes. Discovered several fascinating qualities of Eridanium gigaceous. Or what's Eridanos? So Eridanium gigaceous? Gigaceous sounds better. First, the parasite's internal biology is, for lack of a better term, highly modular. An elaborate system of organelles, nerve endings, blood vessels, and hormone receptors exist inside its flesh. When attached to a suitable host, the parasite behaves like a biological extension. A metaphor. Imagine shoving a bypass shunt into a terminal. The shunt is the parasite, the terminal is the host. Yeah, I think I get it. Second, the parasite's nervous system houses a string of kernel-like cells capable of receiving and transmitting neurons. What are the implications? Thought manipulation? Thought control? Third, I've noticed an ambient reverberation in the parasite's nervous systems during periods of intense electrical activity in the Eridanos atmosphere. The larger specimens display a greater sensitivity. There's a direct correlation between the complexity of the parasite's nervous system and its size. Fourth, there seems to be no upper limit to the size of these parasites. I theorize that these caverns may have housed a particularly large specimen. In accordance with company policy, beginning taste ingestion test now. May the law protect my atoms. Dr. Amir Zhao, etc. Well, are these his remains? Or someone else's? Where's Dr. Zhao? Huh? Okay. Well, consider this cave explored. Now on to the rest. Or cave room, whatever you'd call it. I'd like it if there were no more monsters. I think we've killed enough of those things for now. Alright, so we're heading along this way. We came in here. So I'm going to head towards the next set of notes. And that other area, the other way, looks like a way out. Wait, we missed a turnoff here. Thank you. Ah, this way. Oh, it's all colorful. Alright, so there is where we came in, right? I'm gonna go around here, because I don't think we've looked all the way up in here. Alright, there's where we killed those things. Wait a second, there's something on top of this. Mr. Acid! Let's move away now. Breakdown. Breakdown! Keep that just in case. The elite troop armor. Elite. So wait a second. Didn't press it. Change it to a different button and make this button be nothing, but it's the button I'm used to. Corporate authorized the name Eridanium Gagaseous to describe the life form. Once we determine whether the creature is a viable flavoring agent, confection ingredient, or... I've read this. Okay, so these monsters or creatures, whatever, were created in the organic waste of the same terraforming system that operates the atmospheric complex. So we found that survey somewhere before. Yeah, I got the right one. Alright, yeah, nothing new here. Where's the other notes? Down at the bottom, maybe? No. Huh. Just looking for the other notes here, and I don't see them. Well, they've been found in any case. Return to data pads. Return to data pads back to Virgil Henderson outside the Holey Caves. Okay. So we're to find out where this goes. This goes outside somewhere. Stuff. You know, there's more than just that.
Let's show him.
Don't mess with us.
Show him how it's done.
Whoops.
That's the last of them.
Bad. Not much of interest in these caves other than the things we're looking for.
Nice and easy.
That room? Ah! Didn't press it. This goes out? Oh, brother.
Oh, good. A fight.
There's a lot of them. Wait, wait, wait. He's like, oh, goody. A fight. You guys all right? Let's not go out that way. The right way. Sorta. Yeah, that's great. I think I've used that thing accidentally more than I've used it on purpose. Well, I'm definitely giving it back to Virgil, but... we'll go out the way we came in. But first, another talk here.
Breathe deep the fumes of revelation.
Hello again?
Welcome back, sister. I'm delighted to extend my desire to aid you, sister. How might I assist?
I'm sure you're delighted. You said you had no further interaction with Helen before her death, right?
Yes, that's correct. She made it clear that my seminars were of no interest to her.
Really? So no messages from her or anything like that?
Your tone of voice seems to suggest that you have information already. Which also suggests you've read my terminal. Clever work, Inspector. It seems even I can't slide my way out of the trap you've so intricately weaved. I admit it. I killed Helen. by mistake.
Huh?
Helen changed her mind and wanted to attend one of my sessions. I, knowing the importance of the seminar, desired to truly galvanize her, though not to stop her heart. So when it came time, I chose to double Helen's dosage of productivity-enhancing herbs. I left her to meditate, and when I returned, she was dead. After that, I entered a less than coherent state. One of my disciples, it seems, witnessed me as I dragged Helen's body out into the wilderness.
Holy crap, so she admitted everything. Did you shoot the body at any time?
Laws, no. I hate guns. If I ever wanted to kill someone on purpose, I would have used a blunt weapon. Nothing quite like clubbing someone over the head.
Huh. The wilderness, though. You didn't dump the body at the Grand Colonial?
Do you jest? The guests at the Colonial eat no shortage of strange things, but I think corpses are perhaps too strange. The creatures of the wilderness are much less picky. Besides, the hotel is ridiculously far. I couldn't have made it all that way without someone realizing I was dragging a corpse.
She's got it right there. I think she didn't kill her. I think Helen got up after that and then was killed by somebody else. You sure Helen was dead?
I'm no medical professional, but that certainly seemed the case. Usually my customers at least writhe or mumble after a session. My productivity-enhancing herbs typically do induce sluggishness, but I suppose they must have been enough to do her in if her constitution was truly that weak.
Well, this is a strange thing to say. She's admitting she killed her, but accidentally, so... But I think she didn't kill anybody. Well, I don't know about anybody, but definitely not Helen.
What? Is this some kind of joke? You're an inspector. It's your job to arrest me, isn't it?
Huh. Now it seems like she's covering for somebody. Look, if Helen's body wasn't where you left it, she must have awakened and walked away.
No. Someone must have moved it after I killed her. One of my business rivals, waiting for me to fall into a false sense of security so they can strike.
Halcyon Helen's body was found at the Grand Colonial. She was killed there.
I don't believe you. I think this is all a trick. You're trying to catch me in a lie. Get me to reveal my productivity secrets.
Not really. The only thing you've done is to be completely negligent.
No. You can't trick me. I finally discovered what's happening. You've been paid off. Someone else learned that I killed Helen and is going to use that information to blackmail me. You think I'm going to let this injustice happen? Ha! Tell the constable that I killed Helen. It's 1,000 times less miserable than whatever my enemies have planned.
Oh. So you're trying to get yourself out of a less horrible fate? Well, the constable is dead. And she is up the wall. Well, I can't figure her out, really. I'll think about whether or not you should be arrested.
I can't say I'm pleased by being kept in the dark. I hope you'll come to your senses sooner rather than later and have me arrested.
Hmm. Yeah. Update Administrator Ludovico. Alright. We'll see what he says. Maybe you want her arrested or no. Wow, so if you run through the caves... I guess that puts us inside the cave? Fine. We sneak past these things. There's just a lot of them. But he's right over there. Oh my, I'm clipping through the stuff.
Here they come.
Well, that one's injured.
No, Ellie!
Whoops, wrong thing. Die quietly. I'm just tired of fighting all these things. I think there's more that way. Hello, Virgil. Guess what I got?
Excellent to see you again, my friend. Hope you've been keeping your head high.
It's him. I swear, it's the guy from Oblivion. I'll serve you well. I think I found everything.
What are these? Research data pads? Not quite what I expected. Let's see what they say. Parasites, caves, thought control. He did what now? Well, it doesn't look like any of this is in violation, but it is disturbing.
Interesting, huh?
And disturbing, a surprised auditor is as foul as failing to file proper paperwork. Rizzos shall pay dividends for my psychological damage. Here's your reward, my friend. Your Wonderful. Contributions to the field of surprise auditing shall not go forgotten. Much appreciation for your assistance, my friend. May your travels through the aether be free of radiation.
Well, okay, that's done. Not going to Tartarus. Virgil Henderson received the requested information for his audit. The board thanks you for your contribution. Alright, so we have report to Ludovico, confront Spencer, report to Ludovico, and report to Ludovico. And then we gotta find room A2. I think we'll go report to Ludovico. What do you think? How do I get off here? Okay. Okay. Much nicer environs.
Inspector, I've just received word that Constable Keane is dead. Please tell me it isn't true.
She was murdered in her office.
Halcyon Helen, Leora Blossom, Maria Keane. There's a murderer on the loose, Inspector.
Really?
You must stop them.
I had no idea.
I don't have Maria to count on anymore, so I'm counting on you.
Whoever murdered her used a needler.
The needler was among Helen's belongings. Whoever stole it must have been able to slip in and out of the hotel. Maria was my sole representative in Cedric's territory. The entire hotel staff is on his payroll. Any one of them could have killed her on his behalf.
Was she important to you?
Maria devoted her entire life to our vision. She was absolutely committed to our company, to our project. I promised myself I'd reward her after we launched Spectrum Brown. I'd make sure she was comfortable for the rest of her life. She was also our voice of reason. She was sensible, and I appreciated her advice. I never got to tell her that.
I don't know why I say enough talk seems like a cruel thing to say. I'll find whoever did this.
Make them suffer, Inspector.
I managed to track down Black Hole Birdie.
I'm pleased to hear that. Birdie Holcomb is a valuable asset to the Rizzo's Rangers property.
Yeah, well.
When Helen was murdered, Birdie was nowhere to be found. The timing of his disappearance is unfortunate.
Unfortunate and suspicious. This isn't a good look for Birdie.
That's ominous. Birdie Holcomb. How have you gone and complicated my life this time?
Birdie was incredibly drunk on the night of Helen's murder. His story isn't reliable, unfortunately.
I do wish Birdie wouldn't take refuge in the glass bottle every time something goes wrong in his life. If Birdie was drunk on the night of Helen's murder, then you're right. He has no alibi. Be plain with me, Inspector. Do you believe Black Hole Birdie killed Helen?
It's possible? I don't think it was him, though. But I'm still investigating my leads.
Understood. I appreciate your candor. I'd like you to continue your investigation. Notify me as soon as you're ready to make a formal accusation.
By the way, Birdie agreed to stay at the Grand Colonial.
I appreciate that. I'd rather keep Birdie within the public eye than let him languish in a bar at the docks. I'll make my report of your investigation into Birdie. Do you have anything else for me?
I've looked into Cedric.
Closely, I trust. Tell me what you found.
Cedric's a slippery guy. I didn't find much to build a case.
That doesn't surprise me. Cedric practically stole his way to Eridanos. He'll do everything in his power to keep you off his trail. With that in mind, do you think Cedric was responsible for Helen's death?
Well, Helen was making money for Cedric. I doubt he has a motive for killing her.
No motive. That's disappointing, because it's exactly the conclusion he'd want us to make. Unfortunately, even I don't have the authority to detain Cedric. His line of work is dangerous, though. There's always a chance for an accident.
Well, sorry to disappoint you, Ludovico. He's alive and well.
Well, I'm glad to hear that. I've already lost Dr. Blossom and Constable Keane, but at least Cedric's alive. The universe is a just place.
Yeah, my reputation's increasing. I'm gonna be, like, revered by Rizzos. I finished my investigation into Jasmine Leva, the Prophet of Profitability.
Ms. Leva earned that title, but not for the reasons you'd expect. The profit business has been profitable for the hotel. Not so much for Ms. Leva's followers. So, tell me, what did you find?
She really wants to be arrested.
She wants to be arrested? That's not the kind of behavior I expect from a suspect. Perhaps she's carrying a guilty conscience. Does the Prophet strike you as a reasonable candidate for Helen's murderer?
I'm still considering my options, but no, I doubt she did it.
I'll bear that in mind. Thank you for the update, Inspector. I'll include everything you've told me in my official report.
Not sure about this yet. So, what does it look like happen? The Prophet of Profitability clubbed her in the back of the head. Or not. She, well, it's definitely she said that she gave her a toxic dose of that herb bundle, whatever that is. Thought she was dead. Dragged her body out. But then the body was gone. So she wasn't dead at that point. So at that point, she got up, walked away, or someone carried her. She came to the Grand Colonial and was killed here by... looks like this guy, Spencer. It's just too easy, though. I mean, she put a W there. It's just too easy. Oh, wow. You've investigated two suspects in the case of Helen's death. You're making progress. If you believe you know the name of the murderer, speak to Administrator Ludovico and make your accusation. Otherwise, continue your investigation and look into any additional suspects. Name the murderer if you're ready. Who killed Halcyon Helen? If you're ready to answer this question, speak to Administrator Ludovico on the penthouse terminal and make your accusation. But we still have to talk to Spencer. Now, to find our way into this... room A2, I really want to know what's in there. Because there's something in room A2 that this gun picks up. This analyzer, whatever the hell it's called. Discrepancy amplifier. So, you want to find my way into that room when I want to talk to Spencer. Anyway, one or both of those will be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.